through the patio doors. It was the most amazing thing. But we broke it. We only made 60 litres. And it completely annihilated and broke. And we kind of nursed it through the rest of the day. And I think we got about 150 litres. But it was just literally from having no cash to buy beer. You know?
Fair enough.
Crazy. It's absolutely crazy. Anyway. Here we go. Hello, baby.
Which one's this?
This is late season. It's just a late season barrel.
This mine, Dad?
Yes. There we go, that looks promising.
Right, let's just
do a taste test here.
Could be awful.
Not.
Is it drier? There's more acid in there.
That's
because
good.
It hasn't been opened.
Mm.
This is like that 2 weeks ago.
No, that's okay. I like that. Jamesy, try that.
It tastes like when the barrel hasn't been opened and air hasn't got into it for 2 weeks. It's much more acidic. No, take a good chug.
Nice.
You can't buy it in shops. There's nothing like this. They just couldn't sell stuff like this in shops. But yeah.
Well, there we go. So what we're doing here is we're... what's this stuff here then, Mark? Let's...
Good question.
Let's tell everybody what this is.
I think they don't tell you what chemicals. It's just... It's cleaner.
Okay. So we're using that there, which is getting anything particularly nasty out. And then... washing every bottle.
And the other stuff is that.
Steriliser there.
Star San, no rinse.
Okay. And then cleaning every bottle out.
You're right, I need to do a video.
And then here we are. Bottle drying process. Quite labour intensive, but
have you seen
the thorough
videos?
You've seen
the one where your dad in.
Yeah.
Well, there's nearly 5 hours.
It creates a vacuum in there that pulls liquid, that pulls air and liquid through this tap. So you grab your bottle. Now it does pull liquid into the back, and that's why you've got a container there. Now that's not going to work for us. So there's CO2 in solution in that cider because it's been fermenting in a sealed container. There's lots of CO2. There's loads of CO2 in solution, which is why we've got that going on. And now you can see why weights and measures is important, because I could have shortchanged someone by 5 millilitres there. So technically you should measure 500 millilitres using one of those into there, find out how high the bottle is, and make a stainless steel like T shaped thing that you can pop in the bottle, and obviously the bottom of the T shape should just so if you're doing it for commercial output, that's what you need to do. But there you go,
that's bottle number one of 2014.
That, in fact, you're right. That's a bit of a milestone. Not only that, but that is the first commercial bottle of the Yorkshire Cider Company ever.
There we go.
Shall we have it?
Yeah.
Now the other problem is, there's a bit plenty of sugar in it, so that's a flat one. That's dead in the water, is that? I'm going to put that in my mantle. I'm going to put that, actually. That's
right, I think you've got to, yeah.
That's going
to
get saved, is that, maybe? But yeah,
no,
fantastic.
There we go.
Cheers.
Oh, cheers.
That's how it
absolutely
works.
And
technically, what goes in the back there, for me,